we'd like you to meet a man who offers what he likes to call uncommon sense. After hearing from him, you may not think it's that uncommon after all. He comes from Boston, a city that has given the world baked beans, the Red Sox, and now we're happy to report a writer named Jimmy Tingle.
No matter where I go in this fine land, folks, I manage to get at least one. You know what I'm talking about, the parking ticket. Now let me explain. I don't mind putting a quarter in the parking meter and renting out that piece of land for 15 minutes. Good deal. What gets me is if you're 4 minutes late, you literally get a ticket for $20. Hey, fellas, give me a ticket for a quarter. I'll gladly pay a ticket for a quarter. Where do you get $20? I mean, in the course of 4 minutes, somebody raised the rent 8,000%. It's not right. It's not fair. It doesn't happen in other areas of life. I mean, if your rent is $500 a month and you're 1 day late, you don't get a bill for $4 million. Come home from work, some guy's towing your house down Main Street. Oh, and if you complain to the city officials, which I have, they get mad at you. Like everything's your fault. Listen, pal, let me tell you something. Let me tell you something right now, Buster. The city needs the money from the parking tickets to pay for the school department, to pay for the police department, to pay for the fire department. I'm sitting there going, wait a second. You need the money from the parking tickets to pay for the schools? I don't understand this relationship at all. I mean, why is the quality of a child's education being influenced by his parents' inability to park? Dad, Dad, the school needs a computer. Oh, don't worry. I'll leave the car in front of the hydrant. Folks, I recently got a parking ticket in a residential neighborhood because I was not a resident of that particular neighborhood. Give us a break, will you please? It's hard enough to find a parking space. Now we're supposed to buy a house.
He has performed for corporate events, private parties, and fundraisers all over the world. For clients as varied as Merrill Lynch, Deutsche Bank, and Fortune magazine, Catholic Charities, and the March of Dimes.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome a very funny man, Jimmy Tingle. You know what the funny thing about immigration is, folks? Even the people who sneak into this country would probably make pretty good citizens based on the risk they take to sneak into the country. I mean, look what these guys from, like, Mexico do to get into America. These guys do, like, a triathlon in the dark just to pick lettuce. I mean, think about that, folks. Walk the desert, swim the river, run across the border. First 10,000 get to pick some lettuce. And people say, we can't let these people in. They're taking all of our jobs. What? Are they taking our jobs, folks, or are they doing our jobs? I mean, let's be honest, folks. When is the last time an American citizen went for a job picking lettuce?
Oh, I've never really been happy.
Here at the bank? All these years cooped up in this air-conditioned office? How I've longed for migrant work. What I'd give to be out in the fields of Arizona when it's 190 degrees. Rip off my shirt, down on my hands and my knees, picking a little lettuce. But can I? No. The Mexicans get all the good jobs.
EMC, one of the world's leading information storage companies, writes, "Outstanding. I would highly recommend him to any organization looking for a little comic relief."
Our next performer has made his name as a stand-up comic and as the commentator on CBS's 60 Minutes 2. Ladies and gentlemen, please make some noise for Jimmy Tingle.
Get on the plane, still no protection on the plane, folks. Now they're talking about arming the pilots, okay? Giving the pilots guns. I honestly think somebody on the plane should have a gun, folks. I don't think the pilot is the person that should have the gun. They already have a very important job. If these people have to be involved in gunplay, who's flying the plane? Get back in your seat. Get back in your seat! Don't make me go back there! Hold the wheel, you son. I said, put that tray table up!
Oh. And because they don't have enough x-ray machines at the airport, folks, they're only x-raying 2% of all the bags that go onto the airport, onto the plane. And I'm saying, we're spending $450 billion on national defense. Break down, get $10,000, and get an x-ray machine. Will you please? My brother-in-law is a dentist, okay? A dentist. He has two x-ray machines. Every time I see him, he tells me the exact same thing. You know, Jim, you're grinding your teeth. Of course I'm grinding my teeth. They're only checking 2% of the bags. Oh. And the questions they ask is, you got to be kidding us. Did anybody give you anything to bring onto the plane? Huh? Tell the truth. Be honest. And did you pack your bags yourself? Tell the truth. Did you pack them yourself? And it's so infuriating, you want to tell the guy, no, I didn't pack them myself. A stranger from the Middle East packed them. I couldn't believe he knew exactly what to bring. Toothbrush for Mr. Jimmy, underwear for Mr. Jimmy. Did I pack my bags myself? Did anybody give us anything to bring onto the plane? Oh, wait a second. Wait one second. Now that you mention it, last night, about 11:15, I'm getting ready to turn in. Doorbell rings. And there stood a man I never met before. He says to me, I heard you're flying out in the morning. Why, yes, I am. Will you carry this on the plane for me? This on the plane for you? I don't even know you. What are you going to do for me? I can pack your bags. Thank you very much.
The New York Times writes, more than comic wit, so cheerfully intelligent he makes his audience optimistic in the face of reality. Make your next event the most memorable one yet with Jimmy Tingle.